Welcome to another episode of Green Garage. I'm here with Phil from PacWind. We're going to put one of these wind turbines in here to make electricity. And explain to us a little bit what we got here.
Well, this is Delta 2, and this was created in Torrance, California. It's an American design, by the way. This is one of four turbines that have been handcrafted by us. And we're going to come in here and install this for Jay so he can have a little green energy here on his
property. Yeah, and hopefully you can add to it. That's what we hope to do.
You put it up in the wind, you collect the energy from the wind, and it just kind of rotates the generator, and we get DC power.
Right.
So a very simple operation.
And explain this. I mean, the real key to this one is the magnets, because you don't open this up, you don't lubricate it, you don't oil bearings, you don't do any of that.
No, this is a standalone system. We've spent a lot of time trying to revolutionized the design for generators, and the only thing that really made that happen was the rare earth magnet.
Yeah.
Without the rare earth magnet, generators would be pretty much the way they've been for the last 100 years.
Yeah. Explain to people the difference between a regular magnet and a rare earth magnet.
Well, a rare earth magnet is about 60 times stronger than a standard ferrite magnet we played with as children.
Right.
These magnets, you have to give them about as much respect as you would give poison or dynamite.
Wow.
We couldn't play with these magnets. They would harm us. So we have to be very careful putting these generators together. But that's what gives us the power. Without these magnets, we wouldn't have this.
So a generator this size, what kind of power are we talking?
Well, this generator could actually produce about 12 kilowatts if we put it up all the way to its maximum RPM.
But, I mean, a normal log out here, we're here in Burbank, California. The wind's blowing, between 7 and 20 miles per hour all day. What kind of power are we making?
We can cruise along at about 2,000 watts, and we can probably get up around 5,000 watts in a nice gusty day. And then if you had storm conditions, you can just see the power start to rise. So like I said, give me a call when you have gale force winds coming through. I'd like to know how much you're making.
We can
plan on the wind typically coming up in the afternoon and the evening, and that's when solar panels fall away.
Right. Okay, well, let's start putting this thing together.